Jandakot sits right on the southern boundary of the Perth airspace. We're only about 10 miles south of Perth Airport, and Pierce is just further north of that. So there's three groups of controlled airspace all very close to each other. Airspace-wise, it's really the departures that catches people out, going a little bit too close, departing a bit wide, and getting too close to those Perth airspace corners. Occasionally going outbound via Armidale is the main hotspot area. They will tend to climb too early. They'll think they're a bit further ahead. They don't want to be low and heading in towards the terrain, so they tend to want to climb early, and that will mean they'll clip that step there. So once they're approaching east of due north of Forestdale Lake, and you've got Champion Lakes there, that's the general area that they can confirm their position. They're well clear of that step, and then they can climb up to 3.5. Otherwise, a bit further east as well, there's a 3,500 step, and they can penetrate that a little bit early on their climb to 5,500 or 7,500. They need to make sure that they're clear of those areas, either Mount Dale or the Wongong Reservoir to the southeast, before they commence that climb beyond 3.5. Yeah, aircraft coming from somewhere like Geraldton, tracking south down the coast, they need to be mindful. First of all, they'll come across the Two Rocks firing range. There's instructions on the VTC and VNC on how to navigate that. They'll then need to be careful of the 4,500 foot step. A lot of aircraft will be at 5.5 or 7.5 tracking south and may delay their descent a little bit too late. So again, a hotspot there that they might penetrate. The other thing is the Alkimos wreck on the coast there is a VFR navigation point. It's pretty well eroded away now, and only on low tide and calm seas will you probably see anything of it. So again, just need to be mindful of their positioning there, because they may be a bit further south than they actually realise. It's just around the Cottesloe area, there's a little 1500 foot lip, which some pilots can penetrate occasionally, but generally the lane of entry traffic, everyone's at 1,000 or 1,500. Restricted airspace tracking north, NOTAMs need to be checked. If you're not sure, it's best to just ask. Contact Perth Centre on the way up and they'll tell you if it's active or not. And again, the instructions on which route to take are very clearly marked on the top of the VTC there.
Generally, in and outbound from Jandakot, the most common mistake would be transiting southbound and going through Romeo 162, or northbound through Lancelin, which is Romeo 146. We don't generally get too many things that aircraft are doing wrong in terms of going through the regular Pierce airspace. And the main reason for that is because the Pierce airspace isn't normally available to civil aircraft, because it's a RA2 status airspace. To avoid the airspace, the best starting point is to read the NOTAMs. Every time Pierce is active, the NOTAMs are going to be raised for all the airspace that's active. And they are different subtly each day, depending on what airspace gets used. Lancelin's a different one, because the custodian of the Lancelin airspace is the Navy. So when the airspace is activated, it's activated on a separate NOTAM, not with the rest of the RAF airspace. And if we do need to stop fire for an aircraft that's having a violation of controlled airspace up there, we can't immediately do that. So it's a particularly dangerous VCA hotspot for us, because they use that range for firing a lot from either ships or cannons on the ground. And it's quite a dangerous bit of airspace when it is active. So the time it would take to get a check fire put in into that airspace can sometimes be 4 to 5 minutes, depending on whether they can get contact with the ship or with the guns that are shooting on the ground. We do get quite a few airspace infringements by civilian aircraft. We get between 30 to 40 airspace infringements a year in the Pierce restricted airspace, but these occur mainly in Romeo 162 and to the north in Romeo 146. We don't generally get too many airspace infringements in other areas, because our other Pierce restricted airspace is active almost all the time, whereas Romeo 162 and Lancelin are activated only via NOTAM, and it'd be quite easy to miss if you weren't checking your NOTAMs thoroughly. All the guys in the RAF are all qualified air traffic controllers. They're not just there to control military traffic. A lot of us have been elsewhere and controlled at normal domestic airports. If you do have a question or a problem, all you need to do is ask. It's not a taboo airspace if you do require access to it. You just need to have a clearance to be in it. Our critical role is safety, and that's the same with any air trafficker. And if you are in trouble, we're more than happy to help.
One of the big things is communication. Difficult for us to communicate if pilots have their radio turned down. If we need to pass a critical instruction, the pilot who needs to hear won't be able to hear. For us to know that you've understood the instructions, those required parts or those required elements in AIP must be read back to us so that we know you've understood what we've said. These two elements are keep your radio turned up so that we can give you the instruction, and the other point of that is that if you are given an instruction, that the elements that are required to be read back in AIP are read back so that we know that you've understood the instruction that we've given you.
1,500 inbound, received echo.
Echo Charlie Uniform, Jandakot Tower, maintain 1,500.
There are going to be times when you are not going to be able to get your call in. The initial call inbound to Jandakot, whether it be on the coast or at 6 South, is if you get a response back from ATC, that is your clearance to enter the control zone. If you've not received that response from ATC, do not barrel on. Get your call in when you can and ensure that you're listening out so you don't over-transmit other aircraft at the same time. There's quite a big mix of aircraft here at Jandakot, and that's probably only going to increase over time.
Jandakot Airport operates with fixed-wing and rotary aircraft, so it is important for fixed-wing aircraft to just be roughly familiar with the instructions that the rotary aircraft are getting so that they can keep an eye out and maintain that situational awareness. The tower will always give helicopter aircraft as traffic, so you shouldn't not know where they are. But things like turning crosswind too early, that will cut off a helicopter in their standard circuit pattern. Their circuit pattern is within the fixed wing circuit. So just be really careful, that always check your wing and be aware of helicopter traffic before you do turn early. Or if you need to, just request an early turn and tower will be able to advise.
At Jandakot, the helicopter operations are similar to the fixed wing once we've taken off. When we depart Jandakot, then we take off parallel the active runway, and our departure altitude is the same as fixed wing, which is 1,000 feet. And when we come back into Jandakot, we still come in at the same height as fixed wing at 1,500 feet. We descend inside the fixed wing circuit, but still fly the same circuit pattern, just inside, descending to 1,000 feet, making a normal downwind call, and then getting a clearance to land or a cleared visual approach to our nominated landing point if the tower can't see it, if we're going to land at the hangar. Victor 66 has been set up as a controlled airspace route for student practice. It looks like a VFR tracking route on the VTC between the Lakes Mine, Helena River Reservoir and Canning Dam, but it is not. It's been purely set up for students wanting controlled airspace exposure. The student then would track to Canning Dam, get a clearance, and then track Helena River Reservoir, the Lakes Mine, at normally 3,500 feet. And then if they're coming back the other way, they get a clearance to come in at the Lakes Mine, Helena River Reservoir, and then Canning Dam at 2,500 feet. So clearance is required, but it is not really a VFR tracking route. Anybody departing to the east and northeast, or returning via the east or northeast to Jandakot, should remain to the east and south of Mount Dale and at less than 3,500 feet.
Clear, Victor 65, maintain 1,500. Victor, leave it at